once again! This is Akuma Kazoo. I've been playing Genshin Impact for the past week or so, and today I will share with you what I like, what I enjoy, and what I am concerned about. My experience for the game so far comes from having reaching AR31 and soon AR32. Let's start with what I like first. Paimon as a partner in your journey in Genshin Impact is definitely something that I love.
Okay, thank you for the info! Hey! Leave some chicken mushroom skewers for Paimon! So insensitive! You have no idea just how tiring fooling around... Wait!
The English VA for Paimon is extremely on point and definitely a great delivery overall. In exploration expect and how it naturally jousts into the general gameplay, it's also extremely fun and satisfying. More often than not, you will be distracted from your quest area by a treasure chest here or a shiny object there, and this will have a chain reaction bringing you further and further away from where you should go. The puzzle solving, the mini games, the ghost guiding, the challenges, and the combat in between all of that makes the whole gameplay super enjoyable as a whole. Completing all of the above also gives you rewards like Primo Gems, which you will use for wishes, which essentially is the summoning slash gacha system in the game. Oh my goodness, I got one more! I mean one more, by that I mean one. This is my first extra. Combat in Genshin Impact is relatively simple, but having enough depth to keep you engaged. In the beginning, you will feel like a badass with all the various elemental reactions, but as you progress further into the game, you will meet enemies which have various elemental shielding. You will need to know which element reacts with your enemy's shielding to remove those shields effectively. So the elemental system in Genshin Impact definitely adds a layer of complexity in the gameplay overall, and you want to know what each elemental reaction does to make use of them to the fullest. All in all, just based on what I've experienced from the start and until AR21, I dare say that Genshin Impact is definitely better than some $60 AAA games released in the past 2 years. That being said, I have my concerns as well. I think my concerns are mainly due to how everything is so good, how everything flows so well, and how progression is steady pre-AR30. Post-AR30, you'll realize that the content that Genshin Impact 1.0 is now minus most of what was fun before. I believe this is where many will choose to stop playing entirely, or come back only when Genshin Impact releases a new region as an update. Exploration will not be as rewarding now, since you will just be trying to squeeze out what is left and available that you have not found, though for completionists, this should also be okay overall. Your endgame goal for Adventure Rank will be to reach AR40 for World Level 5 as soon as possible, since that unlocks the farming of 5-star artifacts. In summary, once you are done with all the available main quests, side quests, and exploration, you'll be left with your daily commissions, 2 weekly bosses, as well as how you want to use your resin. For me, this is personally a good thing, since I know now that I don't need to play as much comparatively to when you're first starting out. You will have a guaranteed 2200 adventure EXP every day if you complete your daily commissions and use at least 160 resin per day. Since you will need around 73,175 adventure EXP to reach AR40 from 30, that will be around a month if you just do dailies, which you know is not that bad to be honest. I'm already close to AR32, and if you consider 3 more storyline quests unlocked at AR32, 34, and 36 respectively, getting to AR40 should definitely be faster than a month. You also have to spend time hunting monsters outside of domains and elite bosses for character and weapon accessory materials as well as talent level up materials. So while there won't be much exploration once you're done with it for the most part, there's definitely still stuff to do in Genshin Impact, it's just that it may not be what you enjoyed earlier on. This is where the grind starts, but honestly I'm not really that worried since you can see from the entire world of Teyvat that miHoYo as a company definitely loves Genshin Impact. All in all, I've enjoyed Genshin Impact very much and highly recommend this game to anyone. I mean, it's free to play, and from what I know, it is possible to clear all the content with the game given characters. Let me know in the comments if you like Paimon as much as I do and why. As always, if you enjoyed this video, smash the like button. Name has been Akuma Kazoo, God bless, and I'll see you all in the next video or at the livestream every Thursday.
See ya!